Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lesson in this series on Django Fundamentals, where we will be taking a look at authentication. Okay, so let's get started. So first of all, we want to make sure we have a login page. So we have one here. Perfect, this is our login page. Good. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and create a login form. Okay, so we're going to do this with Django's built-in authentication form. So let's go and do that. So let's go to our app to do and go to forms.py. Now what we want to do is we want to import a few things. So we're going to import, first of all, Django's built-in authentication form. So let's do that. So we're going to say from django.contrib.auth.forms import authentication form. Okay, so make sure you import that. The next thing that you want to do is you want to import a password input and a text input widget. Okay, so our text input widget will be for our username field, and our password input widget will be for our password field. Okay, just like HTML, when you have the two inputs, in this case, our text input is for our username and our password input is for our password. So we can now import those widgets. So it is, of course, from Django. .forms .widgets import password input, and the next one text input. Okay, so you just want to make sure you import these two here. Okay, great. Now we can go on and create our actual form. So let's go ahead and do that. So here I'm just simply going to say class login form, and then I'm going to, of course, inherit authentication form in my class here, login form. So here I can say authentication form. Okay, perfect. And I can now focus on my widget. So I'm going to set my username to, of course, a text input widget, and my password to a password input widget. So let's do username equals. Okay, and then we can say forms. Dot char field, and then we can say widget equals text input, and open and closing parentheses. Next we want to create one for our password, so a password widget. Let's connect it, and we can say forms.char field widget equals password input, open closing parentheses. Now you'll see that forms isn't picked up. Okay, now to fix this, we need to simply go ahead and import our form. So we'll say from Django import forms. Okay, and we need to just say equals here. So there we go. So we've done our login form, that's perfect, and our forms here has been imported. So that is great. Okay, so we've done what we needed to do. Now we can go ahead and create our login URL. So we can go to our URLs here. Okay, and I'm going to create another URL pass. Okay, but I'm just going to borrow this comment and underneath it and just replace the text here with login a user. Okay, so I'm aware. Okay, we can also just some space, so I'm going to copy this URL pass, and here I can just simply say login, and my views, I'm going to call it my underscore login actually, and I'm going to set the route to my login, and the name parameter here, my login. Okay, so make sure you set your URL pass, remember your route where you want it to go in the URL, your views, and your name, and the name here as well. Okay, so make sure you've done that. Next, we want to actually get straight to it and create our view. So let's go to views.py. Okay, and we need to make sure that we actually import our login form here. We want to import this. So we can go ahead here, and actually, we're already importing from forms here. So we can just put a comma and look at the form here, and it is login form. So we can just move it here and say login form, just like that. Okay, and we need to import a few things here. So the first thing we need to import is auth. So we can say from Django contrib.auth.models.import.auth. Great. All right, and what we can also import is our authenticate method and login and logout. But when it comes to, of course, setting our logout and login view, there are different ways to do this. So I think just to make it easy and simple, we're just going to use auth. Okay, so let's keep it there for now. Now we can scroll down. And I want to create a view now. Okay, and this is to log in a user. Now, if I go to urls.py, okay, my view that I must create, the function must be called my login. So I can go ahead and say def my underscore login. So we can see this is the same as it is here. So we define the same name. Now we need to, of course, since this is we're planning on handling views, we need to pass in the request object. Okay, so what we can do next is we can go ahead and say form equals login form. So we can create a variable for that. Then we can actually do our logic here. So I'm going to say if the request.method is equal to post. Okay, I'm going to say form is equal to login form. And I need to pass two things in here. I need to pass in a request, and I also need to say the data that I submit in my form is going, I want that to be posted to my database. So I'm going to say request data equals request.post, just like that. Okay, great. Now next I want to say if my form dot is valid. So what this is going to do is going to check actually if this form here that I've created is actually valid. If it is, I'm going to actually check if the user authenticated, and I'm also going to get the username and password. But first of all, we want to get the username and password. So I'm going to say username equals request.post.get, and I want to get the username. Perfect. Next, I'm going to say password equals request.post.get, and I want to actually get the password. Okay, there we go. Okay, perfect. Now I want to actually authenticate my user. Now, to actually do this, we need to import a package. So this is one package we do need to import. So we go down here, and what we're going to do is we're going to import a few things. So we're going to say from Django. Okay, and I'm going to say .contrib.auth. And then I'm going to go ahead and say import. And I'm going to say authenticate, login, and login. That's fine. Authenticate and login. So we may not need to use login, but we need authenticate. So make sure you import this here. Now let's go back. Okay, back to where we were. And we can now go ahead and say user equals authenticate. And I can pass in three parameters. First, a request. Then I need to set the username equal to the username and the password equal to the password. I will explain this now. So the second parameter is username. So of course, we're going to check, of course, in our database, if the username from our database is equal to the username here and the password from our database is equal to the password here. So if there is a match, I want to authenticate the user. Okay, so this is what this authenticate function does. Okay, now we need to add some if statements to actually check here. So if the user, so the user here, okay, is not none. So basically we're checking here, if the user basically exists, then I want to authenticate the user. So I'm going to say auth, and I want to log in the user, and I'm going to say log in user. Perfect. Now what I want to do is return a HTTP response. Okay, so in case you didn't follow the other videos, make sure that you import this line here from django.http import HTTP response. So make sure you import that there. And I'm going to say here, you have logged in. Okay, So I'm just going to return a basic HTTP response if the user has logged in. So you'll see a blank page just showing this line. It will output this. Great. Now, the next thing we need to do right alongside our code, we need to make sure that we import a context. We need to set our context dictionary. So here, by if request method equals post, under the, down this line here, we can say create a context dictionary. And here I'm going to pass in form and form. Okay, so my key is form and my value is form. So I'm taking this form here and I want to render this form on our HTML template. So I need to render it. So I'm going to say return render. And then I'm going to say request and my login.html and the context equals context. Great. So there we have it. Great. Now, what I want us to do now is I want us to actually go ahead and just sort out our actual HTML form. So I'm going to go to templates, mylogin.html. And what I need to do is create some markup, but I can borrow from here, from create task. So I'm going to copy this and I'm going to paste it here. So you can take a good look. So have a form here. All right, the method is post, autocomplete is off. Okay, it's not a problem. CSRF token, we have to always pass it when we're submitting forms in Django. We have our form.asp here. So basically what this is going to do is going to add a field for username and a field for password. So you could say a username and a password sort of field, which is represented by text and password widgets. Okay. So that's all this is going to do. We could technically go ahead and say form.username, okay, just like here, and form.password as well. Okay, but this won't look very nice when we actually see our login page. So it's best to just keep it form.as_p because this adds sort of a break, like a space in between all the fields, and you also see it nicely oriented. Okay, and then we're going to have our submit button as well. So when we send this post request, we're going to submit, of course, in the process. So we can double check here. So here is our code for the views.py. So you can have a look here. So I've explained everything. So we are basically taking here our form, which is, of course, here. And when we submit it, we are, of course, going to go ahead and request post. If it's valid, we're going to get everything here, authenticate our user, log in, return a HTTP response. If for some reason it fails, then it's just going to stay on the same page, okay, on my login. So it's just going to stay on this page, my login, if there's a failure. If there's a success, we're going to return a HTTP response that says you have logged in, okay. But perfect, let's actually test this out and see how it works. So let's just close this up here. Okay, so let's do it. So before we actually get to the login, I just want us to go to index.html and just create a link to login here. So I'm going to make it very simple. So I'm just going to I'm just going to copy a bit here and I'm going to set my URL here, the path here, to this my login. So whenever you're working with this URL tags here in a HTML template, make sure you always refer to the third parameter here, which is name. So in this case, it's my login. So I'm going to go here and I'm just going to replace this with my login. And here I'm going to say go to login page. Okay. So make sure you do that. So this is on a normal HTML page, so index.html. So that's fine. And I'm going to close this up. I can go back to my views. And technically, so everything, if everything works, we're going to see this response you have logged in. So let's go back and we can refresh. And there we go. We see a link that takes us to our login page. You'll see at the tooltip in the bottom left corner, it's saying my login. So let's go to login page, enter a username and password. So let's say, for argument's sake, let's go back and let's say you don't have a user. You can go ahead and register a user quickly. So here I'm going to say Arno3. I'm going to put in a fake email address. So just keep in mind that username that I'm using, Arno3. So that's my first name and of course just the random number 3 there. So I'm going to register a user. Perfect. I'm just going to go back to the home page now and I'm going to log in. So I'm going to use that exact username and password that I just created. So if I submit, there we go. You have logged in. Okay, and that's exactly what we needed to see, and everything's working perfect. Now, let's say, for example, something went wrong. So I'm going to go to the login page. I'm going to say something, use a fake username, fake password, and submit. Okay, so we can see here, we get some validation here saying, please enter a correct username and password, and just telling a note saying that the fields may be case sensitive. So as you can see here, there is some default validation. This doesn't look great, but I'm just teaching you authentication like in its rawest form. So these are just very short and sweet tutorials just to help you on the right step with simple coding here. So let's just sum up what we've done. So we imported, of course, our authentication form from Django, imported a password input and text input widget, which serves as our username and password fields, okay? And then we created our URL path. So our route here is my login. Our view is my login here. Okay, that's what we called our function. And the third parameter is name, my login, okay? And this is important for, this is important for stating the login route here. So in this URL tag, this is what references name. All right, then we have our views here. So as I explained, I'll close. So I'll close view forms, URLs, views. Okay, and as we can see here, this was our view to authenticate the user. If the user authenticated, we saw the message. If there was an issue, there would be validation and you wouldn't access this HTTP response. Okay, then we can see in index.html, we just had this one link to go to our login page. And then this was, of course, our login page here, where we had form.sp, which encapsulates, which you could say contains our username and password. And then, of course, we had the submit button that submits a post request that we handle in our views.py. Okay, so that's it on authentication, just a quick introduction. So I hoped it was helpful, and that's it.